Hello. On behalf of the Putnam County Playhouse, this is Jack Randall Earls, the man in the chair. I'd like to welcome you here today, and we're going to be getting to know board member Mike McClaine. Hi, Mike. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks, Jack. I'm looking forward to it.
Yes. You've been with the Putnam County Playhouse for many seasons, been on the board many seasons. You work off stage. You do a lot of tech work. You work in the pit. You make popcorn. You sell tickets. You clean up. You do a lot of things. I want to talk a little bit about how you got started at Putnam County Playhouse. What was your first production, and how did you get involved?
Well, it actually started way back in 1964. I was 9 years old. My mother took me to see Playhouse Productions then at Speech Hall, at DePaul campus. And the first show I ever saw was The Silver Whistle.
Yes.
So then later in 71, as in high school, I got involved in the Playhouse. Then it was at McAnally Center at the time, now Parker Auditorium. And that was, I was on stage crew and set construction for Hello Dolly.
Fun with show. Adeline Canoy.
Yes, exactly. And large sets. They had room for large sets and whatever. It was a lot of work and a lot of fun. And that's when I really got involved in that aspect. And then in 77, I played Mayor Shin in The Music Man, also at McAnally. Yeah.
Who and directed then, that production?
A friend of mine, Tom Alban.
Tom Alban.
Yeah. I think it may have been one of his first attempts. And but turned out okay.
All right, I bet it did.
Past the thousands.
Of course. Of course. Now, when you work up in the pit and you play in the orchestra, what instrument do you play?
Well, I play drums, typically percussion. Usually it's the trap set, drum set itself, and then also lots of other hand percussion instruments that most musicals call for, like woodblock, triangle, finger cymbals, of course cowbell. You can never have too much cowbell.
No, right? That's true. That's true. And also it's very good to have you up there when one is giving the curtain speech. You can always punctuate something that is
yes,
said.
That's always fun. Gets a laugh.
Speaking of the pit, do you have a favorite musical that you've played for here at the Putnam County Playhouse?
Yeah, I enjoy playing, period. I've played since I was in third grade, so I love playing drums. But I guess probably my favorite music that's the most fun for a drummer to play anyway is from Joseph. The overture is exciting and powerful and a lot of drum parts in it. And a good rock beat, which is easier to play.
Yes.
On a similar note, Rodgers and Hammerstein music is not so much fun for drummers. It's not as interesting to play. But then when I'm not in the pit and I'm on stage, my favorite musical so far has been 1776, when I got a chance to play the role of John Hancock.
Yes.
And actually that was my first solo on stage.
Oh, was it your first singing solo?
First singing solo on stage, yeah. It was
directed by Shelley McFadden.
Yeah, I was very nervous, but
That's unusual because it's mostly the whole cast on the show all the time. So I was with you right over there on stage left. That was a lot of fun because you had to keep busy even when you didn't have anything to do.
You had to look busy when there was nothing to do.
Yes. When did you first join the board of directors at the Putnam County Playhouse?
Yeah, that was in 2000. We moved back to Greencastle after being away for 14 years. And I approached Mark Hammer one time and said, you know, if you're ever interested or need any help on the board, I might be interested. So I joined in 2000. And then in October of 2004, was elected president.
Mm-hmm. Well, so now, what are some of your duties as board president?
Well,
besides keeping us in line, which is a full-time job right there.
This group is tough. No, not really at all. First of all, you have to know how to clean toilets. That's a must for a volunteer at a community theater. The usual presidential duties, I guess, would be, planning, calling, and presiding at meetings. assigning committees and then overseeing those, being the spokesperson in the community if the need arises, preparing budgets for the year, reviewing financial reports on a monthly basis, also sign contracts with respect to royalties and that kind of thing. So it's, even though the Playhouse is shut down during the winter, you know, as well as I, a few of us on the board have things to do all year, yes. All year long.
Yes, so. Never stops. What do you are you most proud of as of accomplishing during your terms as president?
The thing I'm most proud of is the volunteer spirit of the board. It's such a great group to work with, and our whole goal is to make the Playhouse better and promote theatrical arts here in the county and surrounding areas. But secondly, I'd say it's just I continue to be humbled that I have the opportunity to even be president of an organization like this. It's really a thrill and a blessing. Thirdly, I'd have to say that I'm very proud of the Cast Rehearsal Center. In 2007, that structure was completed, and as I mentioned, when I started back in 2000, there was talk on the board of needing a rehearsal space, something, because we were, as you know, better than anybody, we rehearsed outdoors. And so I took that as kind of a challenge, and I had an architect program on my computer at home, and I would go home and play with possible designs. And I had a friend who was a builder, and I talked to him about it, what's possible and whatever. And so I just looked into that and finally came up with a plan that I presented to the board as that could work. And we had half the money in the bank, had a fundraiser, and we leveraged a loan at the bank to get the rest of it. Paid off in 4 years, I might add. Mm-hmm. And we ended up with the structure we have today, 4,000 square foot, two-story, air-conditioned and heated, space for rehearsal, cast restrooms, cast dressing rooms, and a 2,000 square foot costume loft, which Shelley does a great job with.
Yes.
That is the
yes.
envy of community theaters
yes.
all around.
Yes.
So that's, I think, a pretty good accomplishment.
Oh, I think so too.
For the whole board.
I believe so too. And I think looking back on some of the things you mentioned we used to have to do, now we don't have to. People who just are becoming involved with the Playhouse don't know what it's like to rehearse on a cement slab outside or to dress in the little barn and run over here in the rain during the scene changes.
That's exactly right. We changed the way we do production.
Yes, we did. And I also do want to mention that you were behind the drive to add an additional stall in the ladies' dressing room. So that... A lady's bathroom.
Yes.
So that's certainly that was certainly welcome news to our patrons. Yes. Michael, do you have an amusing anecdote or tale about something yeah. that's happened off stage or on stage that you can share with us?
That we can share.
That
yes.
we can share.
This
yes.
This is good for all audiences. In 2013, I had the opportunity to play the part of Elwood P. Dowd.
Harvey.
In Harvey. Yes.
Directed by.
Jim Rambo, I believe, yes. And it was an evening or a performance, and it was raining. And this is before we had a chance to fix the roof. And so we had a leak right over there. I was downstage right, and some other cast members were there too, but because of a leak on the roof, we had a puddle on the stage, and I didn't see it until I stepped in it. And so, without missing a beat, I just looked up and said, "Harvey." And the other cast members, I don't know that they appreciated it so much because that wasn't in the script, but I felt like it was in character. I don't know.
I like that. A lovely moment
yeah,
between you and
yeah.
Harvey
yeah.
and 198 people.
Yeah. Yeah, wondering what happened.
Well, thank you, Mike. I certainly appreciate your talking to us today. And in closing, let me ask you, when you get to theater heaven, what do you hope the director will say to you?
I certainly hope I pass the audition.
Very good. Thank you, Michael. I appreciate it very much. And thank you for joining us. On behalf of the Putnam County Playhouse, this is Jack Randall Earls, the man in the chair, and we hope to see you again real soon.